Good morning, New Zealand. Welcome to a new year of breakfast, and welcome to Tim Wilson, who's joining me on the couch for a couple of weeks.
Thanks a lot, Pippa. I can't believe the holidays are over already, but it is fantastic to be with you this morning. Here's what we've got coming up on the program. It's one of the worst earthquake disasters in history. We hope to cross live to Haiti for the latest on the devastation and the mammoth relief effort.
A royal hungy and a handshake. We follow Prince William's third official visit to New Zealand and chat to legendary British photographer Arthur Edwards, who's followed the royals for more than 30 years.
How many bombs have you disarmed?
873.
You're a wild man, you know that?
And this is the movie. Boom, look at that. That's the movie tipped for top honours at today's Golden Globe Awards. We'll tell you all about it and cross to Dominic Bowden on the red carpet.
Plus, after 8, we have an exclusive interview with David Attenborough in Antarctica. Very, very busy day. Lovely to be back with you for 2010. First up, here's Peter with the news.
Good morning. For the first time in days, emergency aid is finally beginning to reach survivors in earthquake-ravaged Haiti. As many as 3 million people are waiting for supplies. Many of those supplies are caught in a bottleneck at the airport. The UN Secretary-General Ban Ki-moon has arrived on the Caribbean island to assess firsthand what he's describing as the worst humanitarian disaster in decades. It comes as more than three more people have been pulled alive from the rubble 5 days after the magnitude 7 earthquake struck. More than 100,000 people are feared dead. Saddam Hussein's cousin, known as Chemical Ali, has been sentenced to death by hanging for ordering the gassing of Kurds in Iraqi Kurdistan in the 1980s. Ali Hassan al-Majid received the death sentence for his involvement in the 1988 poison gas attack on the Kurdish town of Halabja, in which 5,000 people died. Most of them were women and children. It's Wellington's turn to host Prince William today. Day two of the Royal's New Zealand visit will see him attend government functions and open the new Supreme Court building. This follows a hectic tour of Auckland, as Amy Kelly reports.
A crash course in New Zealand culture. The Prince pulling his own welcome feast out of the ground. A sign, perhaps, that times are changing, that the stiffness and formality of royal tours is a thing of the past. The Prince arrived not on a private plane, but a regular Air New Zealand flight from London. Some passengers sitting mere rows away.
I've lived in the UK for over 40 years, and that's the closest I've ever come to a member of the royal family, so, yeah, quite exciting.
The first New Zealanders he met, the Governor-General, then the Prime Minister, leading to small talk about the weather.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, very nice. Great. Thank you. Sorry, the weather isn't as superb as it was yesterday.
Then he was off to see developments for the World Cup at Eden Park with local rugby royalty. Later in the day at the waterfront, the Prince mixed with locals, not part of his busy schedule. There were royal handshakes all round, the Prince posing for pictures and talking Kiwiana.
I've been using pineapple lumps.
With all the natural grace and charm of his mother Diana. It's something his English fans say just wouldn't happen back home.
You'd have to be here from about 4:30 this morning, then there'd be about 4,000 police, and you would never, ever, ever get a glimpse of him. Trust me, you wouldn't.
The Prince then set sail, taking the helm of one of our America's Cup yachts, but not before putting in some hard work on the grinders, and no doubt working up an appetite ahead of his Kiwi-style feast. Amy Kelly, One News.
Some Auckland train commuters may face delays this morning because of signal problems at Newmarket. KiwiRail says there are issues with the traffic signals at the recently upgraded Newmarket station, which was supposed to be fully operational for the first time today. This means the lighter holiday train schedule will continue with fewer train services and buses running replacement services. Contractors are not sure when the signal system will be fixed. Now to sports, and all the attention centred on American cycling legend Lance Armstrong, but it was Dunedin rider Greg Henderson who upstaged everybody in the pre-race Tour Down Under Criterium in Adelaide yesterday. More than 100,000 people lined the streets for the race, many hoping for a glimpse of Armstrong. But it was the newly formed British Sky team who positioned Henderson, their sprint ace, for the decisive dash.
But this is the final kick for the line, and it looks to me as though it is going to be a 1-2.
two for Team Sky, because it's won by Greg Henderson with CJ Chris Sutton in second place.
The 51-kilometre race wasn't counted as part of the official six-day Tour Down Under, which starts tomorrow. In Hobart, rain came to the rescue of Pakistan in the third cricket test against Australia. The tourists were reeling at 103 for 4, still 335 runs short of the target set by Australia in the third test. Channel 9's Chris Hodgkinson with the wrap on day four.
Pakistan huddled up ahead of what appeared mission impossible. Ponting and Katic made their intentions clear as Australia quickly built on its 277-run lead.
Ah, great shot, Ricky Ponting.
During the summer, Katic has been out on 98 and 99. Today, he had 100 reasons to smile.
A lively 100 from Simon Katic.
He didn't add to that his quest for quick runs, ending in the hands of Canaria in the outfield.
Very unselfish from Simon Katic.
Ponting's hot streak brought undone by hot spot. The skipper's 89 second innings runs, taking his tally to 298 for the test. Haddon and Johnson were promoted up the order but added little, Ponting pulling the pin with Australia ahead by 437. After a first innings century, Salman Butt was riding his luck, Bollinger ensuring his good fortune didn't last long.
Rips it through and knocks the pegs flying.
Siddle chipped in with the wicket of Farhat.
Oh, that could well be out, yes, good healthy edge.
Mohammad Yusuf showed some defiance before Watson's reverse swing again had Australia moving forward. Yusuf and Umar Akmal trapped in front.
Just going down the leg side, no, he's going to give him out as well.
Now to the top stories on tvnz.co.nz this morning. There are reports the BBC is considering dumping Britain's Met Office as its main weather forecaster and hiring one from New Zealand. Tiger Woods is believed to have checked into rehab for treatment for sex addiction. And reality TV star Kim Kardashian makes a deal to marry Reggie Bush if his team, the New Orleans Saints, wins the Super Bowl. Do you think they'll make a TV show about that? Probably. That's news and sport for now. More for you at 7. Remember, the day's news is here on One News tonight at 6. Now back with Tim and Pippa.
Thank you, Peter. They are making a TV show about that.
Of course they are.
Do you know Kim Kardashian? Does that name mean anything to you, Peter?
I think I might have seen it when I'm surfing, you know. Is she on the E! Channel a bit, is she?
She is. See, Tim is all over this stuff.
Look, I can't believe this. Peter Williams has Kim Kardashian's Twitter feed. His phone's constantly going off. He's getting updates all the time. And now he pretends ignorance about it. I thought it was interesting, too, that Tiger Woods is now going into sex rehab. Didn't the scandal break about 3 months ago? It's like, so I just have to get a lot of sex in before I go into the rehab. I'll be back in 3 months. Anyway, from sex to weather, and we'll cross now to Tamati. How's the weather doing?
Hey, very good, thank you, Tim. Hey, good morning, Tim. Good morning, Pippa, and good morning, Peter. Good morning, New Zealand, as well. Here's to a very, very good 2010. I hope that your summer was very good. I hope that you got a bit of nice weather to enjoy it. But, hey, it's not all about the weather, you know. As you can see behind me right now, lots and lots of clouds around. It's pretty warm around here, very mild. I think we're sitting on about 20 degrees here in Auckland at the moment, but we'll have a look all around the country today and see what's happening in your part. So let's go down to the south of the South Island first of all.